رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه أما بعد إن شاء الله وحمد الله دونا محاضرة دي ستحات أفراد أودنا بيسيمانتا وحنا نوصو جديد دونا إمام كريم أبو زيد إن شاء الله الشيخ حكاها لدونا The journey of the grave معنى هذا نيتهاي جيد كالله صعوه وقيامها يحكاها لدونا أرمها قيامة أكسر إن شاء الله إن شاء الله so we'll begin our lecture and the Sheikh will be talking about the journey of the grave and إن شاء الله you can ask questions But you have to write down your questions so that we can give it to the Sheikh before the lecture ends, inshallah. So now, inshallah, the Sheikh will begin the lecture, The Journey of the Grave. فَلْيَتَفَضَّلْ مَشْكُورًا مَأْجُورًا بِإِنِّ اللَّهِ
إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ نَحْمَدُهُ وَنَسْتَعِينُهُ وَنَسْتَغْفِرُهُ وَنَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ شُرُورِ أَنْفُسِنَا وَمِنْ سَيِّئَاتِ أَعْمَالِنَا مَنْ يَهْدِهِ اللَّهُ فَلَا مُضِلَّ لَهُ ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله My brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته في سنن ابن ماجه من حديث البراء ابن عازب رضي الله عنهما The Prophet صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم passed one day by the cemetery while some of his companions were digging a grave to bury one of the Muslims. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam rushed to the cemetery and he started looking at the graveyard and tears dropped out of his eyes sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To the extent that the companions saw those tears falling down right in the middle of that graveyard. And then he looked at his companions and he said, لِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْيَوْمِ فَأَعِدُّ For this, my companion, prepare and get ready. وَهَانِئْ مولى عثمان ابن عفان رضي الله عنه كما في سنن الإمام الترمذي He said that every time that Uthman would stand in front of a graveyard he would cry and weep to the extent that he would wet his beard because of the tears. Then they asked him, How come, Ya Uthman, we talk to you about Jannah and hellfire and you don't react in this manner? And when you are reminded with the graveyard, you tear. He said, رضي الله عنه, إني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يقول إن القبر هو أول منازل الآخرة I heard the messenger of Allah saying the graveyard is the first stop from the stops of the hereafter and if it is a comfortable then what comes after it will be comfortable And if it is not comfortable, then what comes after it will not be comfortable. The graveyard, brothers and sisters in Islam, is your next house. Where there will be no remote control, no internet, no Google, no. No air conditioning. Nothing. And you know who will carry you there? The most beloved to you. Probably your children. Probably your father. They will dig a hole in the ground, a hole. You may own a house, huge one, in the service of the earth. But all what you're getting underneath the ground, just what is sufficient for you, body-wise. And they will fill that hole with dirt. They will make sure that you don't come back. Brothers and sisters in Islam, is not a joke. This is not a joke. أَفَمِنْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ تَعْجَبُونَ وَتَضْحَكُونَ وَلَا تَبْكُونَ. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah made a beautiful statement. He said, جعل الله الدور ثلاث. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made three homes for us as we journey back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The first dar, دار الدنيا, this dunya. How long you're going to live? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث في سنن الإمام الترمذي من حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أعمار أمتي بين 60 و70 وقليل منهم من يجاوز ذلك. The lifespan of my followers is between 60 and 70 years. Very few will cross the 7 years line, and of course there are people who will die before that. But the overall average, the majority of the ummah will get to live 60 to 70 years. 60 to 70 years. You spend a third of it asleep, dead in the dunya. Before you go to sleep, you say, بِسْمِكَ اللَّهُمَّ أَمُوتُ وَأَحْيَى النَّوْمُ مَوْتَةٌ صُغْرَى. A sleep is a form of death. Before you go to sleep, you say, Oh Allah, in your name, I shall die and I will be resurrected. And after you rise from bed, you say, Alhamdulillah, الذي أحيانا بعدما أماتنا وإليه النشور. All praise be to Allah who given us life after death. والآية العمدة في سورة الزمر, الله يتوفى الأنفس حين موتها والتي لم تمت في منامها فيمسك التي قضى عليها الموت ويرسل الأخرى إلى أجل مسمى. الآية. So a third of those 60 years you get to sleep. 12 years you have no clue. And by the way, if you do not sleep, they take you to the doctor, they give you sleeping pills. Sleep. You have to sleep. You have to die. There are 12, 13 years you have no clue what's going on until you reach the age of puberty, until you start comprehending. What about the time that you spend a'azzakumullah in the bathroom? Take it out. What about the time that you spend sick? All what you get, 25 years. Net. Net. In the dunya. And then you will have to go to the next dar, the next home. Darul barzakh. Darul qabr. The graveyard. Wal qabr and the graveyard. Imma an yakuna روضة من رياض الجنة أو حفرة من حفر النيران. The graveyard will be one of the two. There is no third. Whether it is a garden from paradise or whether it is a pit from the pits of the hellfire. There is no third. ما في third. خلاص. هو لهذا لذاك. لأبيض لأسود. And then the third دار. دار القرار. The everlasting abode. Again. جنة. Or hell. Brothers and sisters in Islam, I will spend maybe 30 minutes with you. I just want to talk to you about just the first night in the graveyard. وهذا غيب. This is unseen. وكما علمنا نبينا ألا نتحدث عن غيب إلا بنص من كتاب الله أو من سنة رسول الله. And as I, our messenger told us that we never speak about unseen unless you have an evidence from the Quran or the sound sunnah of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And whatever I'm going to tell you today comes almost from one hadith. And I will indicate other hadith if it is not from there. So I don't go back and say again, over and over again, حديث البراء ابن عازب رضي الله عنه والحديث أخرجه الإمام أبو عبد الله النيسابوري في مستدركه وقال على شرط مسلم. First of all, in the way to the graveyard, they washed your body, shrouded it, prepared it, rush with the janazah, asri'u bil janazah, hadhi as-sunnah. Don't delay the body until so and so comes from so and so, don't. أسرعوا بالجنازة هذه سنتنا. Or don't try to transfer the body back to Africa. Don't. Bury. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم في حديث أخرجه الإمام البخاري رحمه الله من حديث أبي سعيد رضي الله عنه أبي سعيد الخدري قال صلى الله عليه وسلم The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says إذا حملت الجنازة على أكتاف الرجال When they carry the جنازة on their shoulder فإن كانت صالحة If the person is righteous and pious His soul will speak and say قدموني قدموني Let me go, let me go. Remember that person already received the glad tidings at the time of death. And I take you back to the first lecture that we shared with you. He already knows that he's going to a garden in paradise underneath the ground. قدموني قدموني Even in our cultural practices, they tell you, MashaAllah, this person janaza was so light, he was fast. This is actually has some basis in the sunnah. قدموني قدموني And if he was not righteous, if he was not righteous, if he was not pious, remember the first one, he is loving the meaning of Allah. Allah is loving his meeting. He is looking forward to go and meet Allah. But the second one, he is hating the meeting of Allah. As they are carrying him and taking him to the cemetery, to the graveyard, he will yell and say, Ya waylaha, ya waylaha, ayna tadhabuna biha? Woe to me, where are you taking me? Slow down, where are you taking me? Slow down. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the graveyard is a terrifying scene. Dark. You remember these days in Africa when we had no electricity? Dark. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كما في صحيح البخاري حديث المرأة السوداء التي كانت تقم المسجد, the woman who used to spend the time in the masjid cleaning it, when she died, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam buried her. He sallallahu alayhi wasallam salla alayha, he prayed on her and he said, إن هذه القبور مملوءةً ظلمة. These graveyards are filled with darknesses. وَصَلَاتِي تُنِيرُهَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَوْ لَهُمْ, and my salah illuminates it for them. Brothers and sisters in Islam, subhanallah, when you die, the most beloved to you, those who love you so much, will not keep your body. They kept Michael Jackson for 4 months, well, 2 or 3 months, and then for 3 weeks, whatever the number was, and then. Wallahi, even if they adore you, I love you, I love you, can you keep my body after death? You know who is the only creation of Allah who will accept you? Your mother. منها خلقناكم. Earth. في معجم الإمام الطبراني حديث سلمان الفارسي رضي الله عنه, الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم said, تمسحوا بالأرض فإنها بكم برة. Wrap your heads in sujood and touch earth, because earth one day will be good to you. Don't just sit on the chair the whole time, sit in the ground. You come to the house of Allah, if unless you have an excuse, sit in the ground, feel earth. Because earth is the only place that will accept you after you die. Even if you own houses. Brothers and sisters in Islam, earth has missed you. That is why earth will give you a hug. Dhamma. إِنَّ لِلْقَبْرِ لَضَمَّةِ. حديث أنس وعائشة رضي الله عنهم في معجم الطبراني أيضا, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, indeed the graveyard has a grip, a hug. لو نجا منها أحد لنجا منها سعد بن معاذ. If someone is to be spared from that grip, earth will squeeze you. If someone was to be spared from that grip, from that squeeze, it would have been Sa'd ibn Mu'adh. The throne of Allah shaked because of his death. وفي حديث أبي أيوب الأنصاري في معجم الطبراني أيضا, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم made a statement regarding a young boy who did not reach the age of puberty. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَلَا إِنَّ لِلْقَبْرِ ضَمَّةِ. Indeed, the graveyard has a grip. لَوْ نَجَى مِنْهَا أَحَدٌ لَنَجَى مِنْهَا هَذَا الصَّبِيِّ. this young boy would have been spared, if there is somebody to be spared. Brothers and sisters in Islam, a fitna that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to seek refuge with Allah after each tashahud in the salah from fitnatul qabr. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhabin al-nar aw adhabi jahannam. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min adhabil qabr. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من فتنة المحيا والممات ومن شر فتنة المسيح الدجال ومن فتنة القبر أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. حديث صحيح. By the way, the day that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم revealed the news of that fitna to his companions was recorded في صحيح الإمام البخاري. أسماء رضي الله عنها was the witness to this. One day the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to his companions, إِنِّي قَدْ أُوحِيَ إِلَيَّ أَنَّكُمْ تُفْتَنُونَ فِي قُبُورِكُمْ مِثْلَ فِتْنَةِ الْمَسِيحِ الدَّجَّالِ. It was revealed to me that you will be tested in your graveyards like the fitna of the Antichrist. You know, the fitna of the Antichrist is deception. Deception. To his right there is Jannah, to his left there is fire or water or fire, and his fire is water, his water is fire. And deception. The same exact thing. When they bury you, brothers and sisters in Islam, and they give you the 15 minutes, if they are family members, that is the sunnah, that you stick around for 15 minutes. Actually, this is the only time that we were told, كما في حديث مسلم, حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص, حديث عمرو بن العاص, that the deceased feels the presence of the living in the graveyard. That's the only time. The only time that we know. Other times we don't know. غيب. And we cannot apply analogy with غيب. قياس. ما ينفع قياس مع الغيب. هو هذا الموقف. سبند مقدار ما يذبح الجزور فإني أستأنس بكم. After you bury me and close the graveyard, spend please the duration of slaughtering of a camel, because I will feel your company as the family members. Other people can leave, but family members, they should stay behind 15-20 minutes, making the dua, Allahumma thabbithu 'inda su'al. Oh Allah, grant him steadfastness when he is asked. Subhanallah, you know the last thing that you will have contact with in this world? Shoes. Wallahi, shoes. Those who buried the deceased, they leave. The deceased will hear قَرْعَ نِعَالِهِمْ, the drumming of their shoes as they leave. The last experience that you will have with this world is shoes. أعزكم الله. Alone. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Hadith Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه كما في صحيح مسلم. حديث أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه كما في صحيح مسلم, يتبع الميت ثلاث. The deceased will be followed to the cemetery, to the graveyard with three. أهله, his family members. ماله, his wealth. وعمله, and his deeds. حسنات, good. سيئات, bad. يرجع اثنان. Two will return. Your money, maybe your son is driving your car to the cemetery. Your car. Maybe he got already your wallet. Right here. I got my daddy credit cards right here. They will leave. They will leave you. والله لا أنسى هذا اليوم يا إخوة. I'll never forget this day, brothers, when I went to bury my father. I went inside the graveyard with him. It was so hot. I left. I can't. You're alone. لقد جئتمونا فرادا كما خلقناكم أول مرة. You came back to us alone like we created you the first time. وكلهم آتيه يوم القيامة فردا. By all the sudden, brothers and sisters in Islam, and we're going to talk about the believer first. If the person was a believer, two angels will come to wake him up. Ruh, the soul, will join the body again in a form that we don't know how. We were not told. But you will be given a life again, dear, body and soul. وهذا في حديث البراء بن عازب. The hadith that I refer to. Two angels, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam described them to be scary. Allah created them scary. Their job, by the way, is to scare you. Whether you are a believer or not. That's what you need to realize. It's a test for everybody. Fitna for everybody. Their job is to intimidate you. Is to scare you. Munkar wa nakir. Sammahum al-Nabi fi riwayah fi Sunan al-Tirmidhi. He actually named them Munkar wa nakir. He described them very scary. They approach the believer. There is a wording of Hadith Abi Hurairah fi Sunan al-Nasa'i. Remember now. Your deeds will be transformed into different forms. Your salah. I see people memorizing the Quran here in this beautiful community. Your Quran will be guarding your head. You prayed five times, your salah will be by your head. These two angels will try to wake you up from your head. ليس من قبلي, not from my side, please. He prayed five times. He memorized the Quran. Go from another direction. To his right, fasting, Ramadan, 3 days out of the month, Mondays, Thursdays, Ashura, the 9th of Dhul Hijjah, if you're not a Haji. Not from here, please. He used to fast. Left. The zakah. He calculated his zakah. He did not just take $5, throw it in the message. Okay, that's my zakah. That's my zakah. No, he calculated the 2.5%. This is how much I make. I have to give to the poor, to the needy. 2.5%. And I will give more sadaqah. Sadaqah. More. The zakah will say, no, please, not from here. From his feet side, the side of his feet, the rest of the ihsan, good deeds, enjoining good, forbidding evil, dutifulness to the parents. He's not mean to his parents. He is obedient to them and the rest of the good deeds. Of course, at the end, he has to be waken up. So they will wake him up. Remember, these two angels are scary in creation. They are supposed to scare you. He will look at them and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make the sun, will make that person about to see the sun is setting. You know what he will say to the angels? Oh, I'm sorry. I haven't prayed Asr yet. I gotta pray Asr. He's thinking that he's in the dunya and he missed Salatul Asr. They will tell him, you will pray. You need to answer these questions for us first. So, no, I'm sorry, I want to pray. You will pray. You need to answer these questions now. Man Rabbuk? Who is your Lord? Who is your Lord? Speak. Who is your Lord? Who is your Lord? Speak. What is your deen? What do you say about the man who was sent to you? Three questions. 5 years will answer them. If you ask a 5 years, who is your Lord? He will say, my Rabbi Allah. He will say, Rabbi Allah. What is your deen? He will say, Deen al-Islam. What do you say about the man who was sent to you? Is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He will answer this. But the person who will be enabled to answer is the one who implemented these three answers in the real life. It has nothing to do with how smart you are. It has nothing to do with you getting A's in your school and no. No. Did you really know who Allah is? Ask an average Muslim now, who is Allah? But we know as Muslims, once we speak about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we cannot use words that are mentioned in the Quran and the Sunnah. You cannot use terms or words just like that. Alfaz fi kitabillah wa fi sunnati rasulillah. Otherwise you're committing ilhad. وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا وَذَرُوا الَّذِينَ يُلْحِدُونَ فِي أَسْمَائِهِ. I tell you something. A Muslim will not hold a 5 minutes talk about Allah. The names and the attributes. توحيد الربوبية. توحيد الألوهية. لا إله إلا الله. طب ask a Muslim now about the most famous football player. He will tell you he wakes up at 7 o'clock in the morning. He goes outside. He likes to eat. He likes to drink. He will talk to me. You have to stop him, please. Okay, okay, that's good. I got it. Thank you. Who's your Lord? Who's Allah, brothers? Who's Allah? You're going to be asked this question. You're going to be asked about Allah in the graveyard. You think just my Rabbi Allah, khalas? La. La. You must have implemented this. You must have. You must have, brothers. Islam, how do you pray? Islam, how do you pray? How do you pray? How do you pray? النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم في البخاري ومسلم حديث أبي هريرة حديث المسيء في صلاته. He was sitting with his companions one day. One of his companions entered the masjid and he prayed right there. And then he came and he said, السلام عليكم. He said, وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله. ارجع فصلي فإنك لم تصلي. Go back and pray. You have not prayed. 3 times. Billahi alayk, how many Muslims that statement can be said to them? Go back and pray. You have not prayed, ya akhi. Ruh salli. Tab salli zayi. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallu kama ra'aytumuni usalli. Pray exactly the way that you have seen me pray. What way are you praying? What way are you praying? ما هو هذا الإسلام؟ ما هو What is الإسلام؟ هو الإسلام إيه؟ ما هو الإسلام صلاة. بني الإسلام على خمس: الشهادة والصلاة والزكاة والصيام والحج. هذا هو الإسلام. How do you pray? How do you fast? You go and talk to the people about the Sunnah now. You're going to be asked about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about his Sunnah. You're going to be asked about him in the graveyard, about his Sunnah in the graveyard. Brothers, the believer, he implemented, he learned, he spent time sitting in the masjid learning his deen. He will say, Rabbi Allah, my Rabb is Allah. Deeni al-Islam, I'm a Muslim. I'm not afraid to be known in the school that I'm a Muslim. I don't change my name from Muhammad to Mu. I'm a Muslim. I'm not scared. I'm a Muslim. I love Islam and I'm a Muslim. Watch me. I'm a Muslim. I'm not going to take my hijab off because they're going to know that you're a Muslim. لا ديني الإسلام. نبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. They will, are you sure? Are you sure? Who's your Lord? Are you sure? Who's your Lord? Rabbi Allah. Deeni al-Islam. Brothers and sisters in Islam, he was granted steadfastness. In this situation, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited the verse, يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهِ يُثَبِّتُ اللَّهِ الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ويضل الله الظالمين ويفعل الله ما يشاء. وهذا هو الحديث. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم at the time of burial he said to his companions, سلوا لأخيكم التثبيت فإنه الآن يسأل. Make dua for your brother that Allah grants him steadfastness, to be firm and confident as he answers the questions of the two angels, because he is questioned now. Upon answering these three questions, brothers and sisters in Islam, a caller from the heaven will say, Sadaqa Abdi, my servant spoke the truth. ألبسوه من الجنة. Exchange that shroud now. That cheap shroud that he got from the dunya. No, give him a new shroud from Jannah. وأفرشوا له من الجنة. And furnish his graveyard from الجنة. ووسعوا له في قبره مد بصره. And extend his graveyard as far as his eyesight reaches. يا الله, this hole in the ground will turn into a garden from paradise, and open for him a gate to Jannah that he will begin receiving provision from Jannah. Brothers, remember I said a minute ago that three things will follow you to the graveyard, two will return and one will stay. Your family will return, your money will return, your hasanat will stay with you. By all of a sudden, out of nowhere, he's alone underneath the ground. a good looking person will appear to him. You know these toys that they sell in McDonald's now called the Transformers? Your good deeds will be transformed into a figure of a person. And he will come to you and say, Abshir, I want to give you the glad tiding. Abshir billadhi yasurruk. I want to give you the glad tiding of everything that pleases you. You will look at this person and say, and I also want to give you the glad tiding. Who are you? Your face really is a pleasant face. Your face is a face that brings glad tiding. Who are you, by the way? Who are you? I don't know you. Who are you? أَنَا عَمَلُكَ الصَّالِحِ. I'm your righteous deeds. فَوَاللَّهِ by Allah, مَا عَلِمْتُكَ إِلَّا سَرِيعًا فِي طَاعَةِ اللَّهِ بَطِيئًا إِلَى مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ. I only knew you quick, fast, once it comes to the obedience of Allah. Adhan, let's go, masjid. Don't say, no, I want to watch the rest of the game. Don't say 5 and 10 minutes. No, right away, go. Let's help the community. Let's raise some funds to help our ummah. Here it is, brother. Here it is. Sariya, fast. No. Don't think about it. أولئك يسارعون في الخيرات وهم لها سابقون. And once it comes to the disobedience, بطيء. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this believer will be showing his place in Jannah. And he will say, as soon as he sees his place in Jannah, he will say, Ya Rabb, O Allah, أقم الساعة. Can you make the hour come? I want to join my family. I want to join my children, O Allah. Then it will be said to him, chill, sleep. فَيَنَامُ نَوْمَةَ الْعَرُوسَيْنِ. He will sleep the sleep of a bride and groom, and he will be waked up the day of resurrection by his beloved. This is the believer. What about the other side of this, brothers and sisters in Islam? As soon as he's buried, still two angels come to wake him up for the test, for the fitna. But remember, فَلَا صَدَّقَ وَلَا صَلَّى وَلَكِنْ كَذَّبَ وَتَوَلَّى. Nothing is guarding him. Nothing is guard. No salah, no zakah, no siyam. He was not a believer in this. They will wake him up. He will be scared, terrified. He will be asked, who's your Lord? He will say, I don't know. What is your deen? What is your religion? I don't know. What do you say about the man who was sent to you? Who? I don't know. Muhammad. Yeah, Muhammad. Yeah, I heard the people Muhammad. Yeah, Muhammad. Are you sure? No, I don't know. مثل حال الفاجر في الدنيا. Any person who follows his desire in this dunya is confused. You find him confused. Every day you have him having a different color. But a person who is sticking to the deen of Allah, steadfast. As soon as he messes up a caller will call kadhab. He lied. Shroud him from the hellfire. Furnish his graveyard from the hellfire. Open for him a gate to the hellfire. And his graveyard, brothers and sisters in Islam, will be squeezed. That his ribs will be displaced. And an angel will come with an iron. And he will hammer him. By all the sudden, his evil, lying, cheating, smoking marijuana, drugs, heroin, alcohol, backbiting, being mean, not taking care of his family, not taking care of his responsibilities, not bringing his children up as Muslims. All of this will be transformed into an evil looking person. Smells awful. Abshir. He will say to him, Abshir billadhi yasu'uk. I came to give you the tiding of every evil thing. Punishment awaits you. Man, your face is an awful face. Brings only bad news. Who are you? You know what he will say, brothers and sisters in Islam? I'm your wicked deeds. By Allah, I only knew you. Slow, once it comes to the obedience of Allah, fast, quick, once it came to the disobedience of Allah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this person will receive extra punishment in the graveyard if he was a liar, if he used to take riba. Hadith Samur ibn Jundub. If he used to commit adultery, if he used to sleep without praying, he will receive punishment every day. النار يعرضون عليها غدوا وعشيا ويوم تقوم الساعة أدخلوا آل فرعون أشد العذاب. Brothers and sisters in Islam, this is the graveyard. I want to conclude by asking you, what kind of a home are you preparing? What kind of a home are you preparing? That's your next home. Some of us, we live here in America and we're always hopeful that we may go back to Somal or Masr and we prepare a home there. And we put a lot of our savings. You know how long you're going to spend on that home until the day of resurrection? Are you preparing a garden from paradise or a bit from the pits of the hellfire? This is a serious question that you have to answer. And it's never late. As long as you're still breathing. قُلْ يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَسْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ لَا تَقْنَطُوا مِنْ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. Allah will forgive everything. Everything. Allah, brothers and sisters in Islam, every single night descends. Subhana, He descends in a way that fits Him. We believe that He descends. We don't know how, but we believe it. Every single night, the last third of the night, He knocks on your door, not literally. He calls upon you. Do you want forgiveness? Wake up. Wake up. Ask for forgiveness. والله يكفي هذا الحديث في هذا المقام حديث أنس. Imagine somebody who was traveling in the desert and he had his camel. On the top of his camel is his provision. And he wanted to take a nap. He went to sleep. And he did not tie the camel. He opened his eyes. He found his camel run away. Ran away. He's in the desert. He went around looking for the camel right and left. He did not find it. He got so tired. He said, I'm going to go back to the place where I was and I'm going to just wait. He went and he passed out. He thought he is done. He is to die. No hope. Then subhanAllah, Allah restored his health to him for a second. He opened his eyes and he saw the camel right there. Can you imagine the joy? Excessive joy. He was so shocked, so happy. He said, Allahumma anta abdi wa ana rabbuk. Oh Allah, you are my slave and I am your Lord. هذه كلمات. If you say this intentionally, takfur. Kufr. But كما قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أخطأ من شدة الفرح. He made the mistake because of the excessive joy. Can you imagine? لله أشد فرح. Allah وهو الغني عنك. He does not need you. Allah does not need you. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم كانوا على أفجر رجل قلب رجل منكم ما نقص ذلك من ملكي شيئا. حديث أبي ذر في صحيح مسلم. If all of humanity will have the heart of the most wicked, this will not decrease anything from what Allah has. He does not need you. إن تشكروا فإن الله غني عنكم إن تكفروا فإن الله غني عنكم ولا يرضى لعباده الكفر وإن تشكروا يرضه لكم. Here he is. He does not need you. But he is more joyful, brothers and sisters in Islam, for your comeback, because of your comeback to him, than this person who made that statement out of excessive joy. Let's make this an invitation to all of us to reflect upon our lives and to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in repentance. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
جزاه الله خيرا خير الجزاء فضيلة الشيخ كريم أبو زيد. إن شاء الله, if there are any questions, please. Sarah. Please, Mahara Manaman, please.